So yes, there are procedural steps you should take when you want to patent anything in Nigeria. But if it's got to do with research, Ma, can you hear me? Question, yeah, can you hear me? I'm answering your question. There are steps that you should take when you want to patent any research idea or anything, but there are protocols. There are things you cannot patent. You cannot patent an entire plant, for example. So you need to know the guidelines, the things that you can patent, and then it's easier when you, that's why we brought this topic up. If you already have relationship with the industry that will drive this innovation that you have, that you think is an, you will think is an innovation where you are in your house, until you come outside and see what people are doing that is innovation. You will know your own is not innovation. You will have to go back home and repackage. So it's in your house, you think it's an innovation until you bring it out. Okay, so having said that, yes, there are steps, and then there are things you cannot patent. There are things that are better protected by trademark, by what do you call that? There are other different levels of property, intellectual property protection that are not necessarily patent. And then also political correctness, yes, but then that's why we are here. You cannot do innovation by yourself on research. You know that one. And I don't believe you that because you are a lady, it's a problem. Just know the right people and know the right steps. It works. We have somebody who has a patent among us. Please, you can throw some light.
Unfortunately, in UNIMED, we don't have a IPTO office yet. However, that doesn't mean we don't support anyone that wants to patent. In fact, we currently have a student that we are putting through, you know, patenting our innovation. And interestingly, we have an intellectual property lawyer in university. So we are working together to get our, you know, product patent. So if you are a lecturer, you have an invention, you want to patent, just reach out to us, you know, in the Central Office for Research and Development. We'll put you through. Work with our lawyer. You know why? Sometimes, you know, when Dr. Agbaji said you have some, I'm very sure many of the people patenting in Nigeria now, they are private, they file it themselves. We don't want to encourage that. We want you to work with the university. We want you to work with the university, because oftentimes to manage patent is very expensive. You need to renew that license every year, so you'll be paying. But if it is university will be doing that, you know, for you. But the only thing is that the university, the inventor, and the industry will share, you know, from the you know, proceed. That is the only thing.
Please, your comments,
thank you, sir. It has to be with the university. There's no way you do it alone. So if you have an innovation and you want to go for patency, there is a form you download for the patency. You fill it and you pass it through the research in the university. The university will forward it to the federal, I think there is one federal industry and whatever. They will now write you back. You write the proposal, all the steps you take in carrying out the research, you tell them, you download them. Then they will call you. You go there, you now present. When you now present, they will now get back to you. They will now write to you, to the university, to give you the patency. Then, thank you very much.
Industry of Trade and...
Yes, ma'am. No, they are willing to assist you from the university. I don't know anybody. And I was giving to Professor Hooper. We passed through the university. We went there. I think there are many universities we met there. They even celebrated us.